Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome here on Flow Sports Network as we have the Greensboro Pride travel up to Rocky Mount, North Carolina to take on our battling Bishops women's soccer team. It is senior day, so we had to delay the stream antics for a bit. But now that we are here, we are ready to get the play-by-play commentary underway. Of course, as always, my name is Damon Hardy, and it is my pleasure to be your play-by-play commentator as we now have Whiteside looking to pass the ball upfield to Stall Fury. But it is taken away by the Pride's number 15 as she does have a pass back onto the field. Now we have a ball over the top. Looks like to the winger number 22 for the Pride. But unable to control it, we're going to have a throw in here from the right side. Long throw in here from the Pride. They are going to maintain possession momentarily. Looks like they try to get a ball towards the midfield, but there's Stall Fury there stepping on occasion. And there's Mia Sherber there getting a deflection to go out of bounds. There's Maddie Edwards there. And now Whiteside looking upfield towards Staub. Staub has the pass back towards Sherber, but it is intercepted by 17. And there's good defense there from Stall Fury. Just having her stand up. Now here comes number 28 having to go up against Nicole Yagi and Alicia Harp, who is finally back on that back line as we have all been anticipating her return. Now AK Evans getting a start. And I believe this may be her second or third appearance of the season. The senior from Warrenton, Virginia. And now here comes Whiteside on a breakaway with no one in front of her. Passes the ball upfield towards Sherber. Surely this is going to be one for the box. As it is lowly driven, it is intercepted afterwards. And now the Pride look to come the other way. Over the top, AK Evans decides to just lay it off the walls. This one takes a few bounces. Pride will start moving downfield, but it didn't take very long for a Bishop to intercept the pass. And that's Yagi there trying to get a ball down the line. It appears to be towards Sherber. There's Thornton there looking upfield towards Yagi. Yagi now has Staub coming downfield. Staub taking space slowly, has a man coming on her side. The Pirates go down the line towards Yagi, but Yagi with not enough speed, cannot get there in time. Now we have one over the top. Thornton now going up against number 23. Thornton gets in front of her, is able to play stand-up defense, make her find a drop-off. Tries to do a little 1-2 combination, but it is going to be called for an offsides. And now here's Grace Walls with the offsides goal kick. The crisp passing was intercepted there keenly by the Bishop midfield. As the right cornerback there had no other option but to clear it. Ball upfield. Appears Whiteside tried to get it intercepted, but it did roll off of a foot. And now here's Edwards. With a 1-2 combo, Edwards now looking upfield towards Yagi. Yagi maintains possession and looks down, finds Staub on the run. Staub now 1-on-2. Looking for an option, makes a move to beat the defender. But it does ricochet off of our defender, so therefore we will have a Bishop throw in. Surely an opportunity at a goal there, just miscommunicated. And now here's Stolfieri. Now appears have a little battle for the ball in midfield. And Stolfieri plays a beautiful ball over the top towards Staub. Staub now, 1-on-1. Looks like it is going to roll out of play, though. Bishops will have the ball. And with that, it looks like we're going to have the very first corner kick of the game. This one in favor of the Bishops. Sherbert's kick sails over everyone. And now Pride trying to get a clearance. And the Bishops would just let this one roll out of bounds and collect the ball for a throw-in. As that runner there was offsides, she was offsides on her first run that was called forward earlier. Perhaps a bit hasty. Couple of ricocheted balls here. Looks like this is finally going to end up with Edwards. Edwards now trying to play one down the line. It is going to roll out of play though. Awesome, Now we have one going down line. Pitch it is going to be played out of play, though. And now here's Harp stepping to the ball first. With that, it has a bishop breakaway now. And now Staub makes a move to beat the defender. She does. Tries to place one into the box, but the defender recovers just in the nick of time. And now we have number three taking space all the way upfield. Staub finally getting there. And there's A.K. Evans with a perfectly timed step for defense. And yet again, that'll be her third offsides call. Beautiful ball there from Harp going down the line towards Yagi. There's Harp once more. And this one's going to be kicked all the way upfield towards our goalkeeper, Grace Wall, so she'll have an easy goal kick here. And now here come the Pride on a breakaway. Having to play good defense there by Maddie Edwards. Well, now here's an incoming free kick. Luckily, even though that it is inside the box there, all 10 players can stay there and form a wall. As this one is going to be converted, the Pride will take a 1-0 lead. That is not, if you are a Bishop fan, how you would like for this game to start out with. Your team plays solid defense, followed by a free kick that is going to be taken. And now here comes Whiteside, determined. And now Pride on a breakaway once more. And they're going to be called for another foul. Grace Wall elects to have four in her wall for this one. As this one is sailed over everything, Bishops will take the ball back heading the other way. As now Bishops take over, having the ball come the other way. There's Nicole Goodwin now into the game for the Bishops. This one is played out of play. Now here's Peyton Staub coming along the right side of the field. Now has Whiteside as a runner, breaks through. Whiteside now making run towards the box, shot towards the goal, no follow up. Surely if there was a Bishop along the left side of the goal, it would have been an equalizing opportunity. Now here's Sherber with the ball. Have another Bishop throw in here coming soon. Yagi lays it off to Sherber, who passes back to Edwards. This is going to take a bounce towards Miss Nicole Goodwin. And now we have a switch on the field. Out of pride, looking on, focusing on possession, however, they do kick a ball out of play at a far distance. This ball is now going down the line. Whiteside trying to play stand-up defense. That was excellent stand-up defense. Just using your body there to shield and let the ball continue to roll out of play. Must give credit where credit is due, Miss number 28. As we now have number three coming down the field with the ball down the line, Nicole Goodwin is there to clean everything up before things got a little bit out of hand. Now there's Thornton there. It's a very nice save. After the defense by the Bishops there, they force a turnover, and now we have a throw-in taken by Harp. Takes a generous roll all the way to the back line of the Pride's defense. And now here's Yagi with the interception, looking to get a switch towards Maddie Edwards. A lot of body-to-body contact there. And now we'll have Whiteside giving it back to Edwards, but it is keenly intercepted by the Pride. And now Goodwin looks to play a ball up towards the field of Maddie Edwards' area. And now we'll look to have another throw in here momentarily. And now we have another breakaway and a shot from the drawback of the leg. Easily attainable there by the goalkeeper, 00, Grace Walls. And now here's Sherber getting a 1-2 combo with Whiteside, but it is botched a bit. And now Harp having to chase down number 3. And there's Alicia Harp once more showing why she is a vital part of that Bishop backline defense. What a ball down the line from Staub. And now coming out of the game is one of our senior captains, Maddie Edwards. And stepping onto the pitch is Kylie Casola. Staub now finding a way to break free. That was an amazing shot attempt there from Nicole Yagi. No one truly expected her to draw the leg back and take a shot at that one. Bit of a high kick there, but nothing was called. As this one is going to deflect off of the Pride, we'll have a quick throw in here. This is up towards Casola, and Faro kind of takes a shot at it. These Bishops are getting a bit more aggressive here in the later half of this. As we are now just under 16 and a half minutes. Time has gone by quite fast. No one's truly settled it yet and gained possession. It looks like that still may be the case. As now here comes Grace Walls to punt this one all the way out of the box. And that is a beautiful breakaway by Whiteside. And an even better ball and take down Central by Kylie Casola. Following suit of the throw-in, looks like Bishop's nearly had possession there. But this one is going to roll out of play, so Bishop's will maintain possession nonetheless. We are getting ready to have our very next corner, this one in favor of the Pride, as this one is up. It is headed, but it is headed away. Bishops catch a break there. Surely that was just a bit more to the right. That would have been the second goal in favor of the Pride. This goal kick was lowly driven, but Bishops will take possession back with. Now Sherber switch across the field to Farrow. Farrow tries to play one down the line towards Yagi, but it is going to roll out of play. Here's Faro playing defense there. And Harp makes a perfect step to help her counterpart out, Nicole Goodwin. And now there's Yagi fighting for possession, and he ends up getting the ball to Kylie Casola, who now has a drop off the field to Thornton. And Goodwin, now looking at her options, decides to go out to Harp. And number 8 tries to play a ball down the line, but there's Nicole Goodwin to thwart all of those plans. And Sherber now playing one over the top. It is headed by Greensboro first, but now Eden Whiteside. It's a ball off of her foot. Very nicely done between Grace Walls and Alicia Harp to use the communication there to avoid the imminent threat that the Pride were presenting. And now here's number 24 with a beautiful ball. Whiteside everywhere in this game so far. Now, Bishops have been awarded a free kick as we are getting ready to enter just under 11 minutes of play. Oh, Thornton takes this one. He is put up to the 18-yard. Goodwin kind of whiffs on this one. And now there's a ball played through, but it is intercepted. But not shortly after the Pride get the ball back. And there's Thornton. And now we're going to have two substitutions coming here. Nicole Yage will step off, as I believe this is now going to be Mason Berrios. Looking for a clearance there. It does get cleared, but not, threat's not over yet. Excuse me, sorry for the lack of talking there. I was almost stung by a yellow jacket that just seems to be following me everywhere I go. But nothing too major has happened in that amount of silence there. This ball is called by Grace Walls as she takes it away. And now here's Meyer working, trying to get upfield at her own pace. This ball was played very quickly there for Meyer. There's Harp laying it all out there. And Thornton now has the ball. Looks up and finds Staub. Staub tries to take a turn. More of a roulette type of turn. Ends up losing possession. That is a beautiful flick, but Thornton is there. A little bit of a cluster there, players falling over each other. And now here's Casola in the ball over to Faro. Called for a foul. Don't disagree with it. And now Bishop's threatening, knocking on the door. Harp puts one all the way up into the box, right into the keeper's arms. Bishop's called for a bit of a foul there, so Pride will take over with possession. Going to the outside here. Sherbert clears this one towards Casola. And Farrow just decides to clear it fully. This one is played out of bounds, so therefore the Pride will now have a throw in as we are getting ready to enter 4.5 minutes left in first half action here at Scaff Field. Great defense here being brought to you by Thornton. But they do force it to be a corner. Luckily, the Bishops are able to at least have a set defense now before things commence once again. And this corner is going to be taken quickly once more. Looking for a clearance. It is cleared. But the Pride do get to it. And this one is put into the box, but we're going to be called for an offsides yet again. This was played all the way upfield towards number 24. Looking to find number 12 in the middle, but our very own number 12, Nicole Goodwin's there to thwart that. Now Whiteside looking upfield at Berrios. Berrios now looking at her options. Mason Berrios now looking in the midfield, finds Meyer, Staub, mishits it. And the keeper is going to be able to collect this one with no problems. And now it appears that it is going to be an easy goal kick looking along. What about the halfway circle? And it appears Goodwin is able to get to it. Now Sherbert with the ball. That's one thing about Harp. She's so springy and ready to go at anything. And it looks like this is going to be time for a substitution. And now a throw in. As we are now entering the final minute of first half action. And now, Pride looking and scoring. What a beautiful 1-2 combo there. That was very unselfish passing and ability. Unselfish play style here being exhibited from the Pride allows them to get their second goal of the matchup in the final seconds in first half action here. And now here's Alicia finding Berrios. Berrios unable to get a good touch on it, but Harp is there first. And now here's a breakaway for number 24. With 16 seconds left, Pride looking to put one more up on the board. Alicia Harp allowing nothing to get past her at this moment. As there's five more seconds, number 24 takes a shot, and it is going to be saved by Walls, as that is going to bring us to the end of our first half action. With the Pride taking an early 2-0 lead, we'll be right back here shortly here on Flow Sports Network.
today?
Hey, we're great. How about y'all?
Everything good?
Jordan's everywhere today.
Turn the AC down.
She interviewed today.
Yeah.
Okay. second half. You know how to make the time show up on there?
Yeah.
What do you do? It's up there normally. Well, it's been up there the previous game. Baden and it, they're just finished, I think. Something you know is going to be a legit break. You can fire 30 seconds half, but I think we're.
Because there wasn't really any but one last period.
Yeah, if we don't have any, it's fine. But I think, what we put on there, we got.
Yeah.
Football is crazy. It's 31-31.
Really?
I mean, like, it looks like a little bit I've watched, it looks like nobody's. They score, four or five plays, go to length of the field, score. Get out there and go as long as you can.
see them leading with a win to start. You know, one was a high school state championship for soccer, men, you know, boys soccer. Mm. Sounded pretty good. Mm-hmm. There was some serious cheering and a lot of people here.
Who, soccer?
Yeah.
High school?
Yeah.
Wow.
I was surprised that they lost some people.
I wonder why men's soccer doesn't play on that field.
This is a really nice field.
Okay, I mean, because
if you ask me if I want to play on turf,
nice grass field.
Yeah, for sure. But turf offers some benefits. Well, if it rains for 2 weeks in a row, you practice all your hand.
I'm just surprised they haven't practiced on that at all either.
Well, they have.
They have.
Play somebody on turf, they're there for all or part of the practice. Like baseball and softball, I've also practiced up there.
Let's say, I know we've practiced up there plenty of times. I've just, every time that I've been on the field, I've just never seen soccer. Or I've always seen soccer just on here. Or,
yeah.
Over there. I believe somebody stopped by my job yesterday and said they knew you were Armbruster. And your wife.
What they do? What they look like?
It was a guy, a woman, and did they have two kids?
What?
No, they had one kid.
How young was the kid?
Probably like 5 to 7. I don't know how I forgot whether or not he said didn't. I have a Wesleyan baseball hoodie on. You can wear anything there at my job as long as you have Tiffy Tomato something. So I just have a Tiffy Tomato hat and wear whatever. I got me 2 baseball clients for hitting lessons.
Did you?
Yep.
You're wearing a sweatshirt?
Yep.
That's pretty smart.
I had like 6 clients in Florida this summer.